Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over how to use and set up destructible meshes. So let's get started. First off, I'm going to quickly show sort of my agenda for this demo. How do you quickly make a destructible mesh, fracture it, talk about levels in depth, particle and sound effects, applying a radial force actor, and then also adding some support to it, and then also how do you make the impact from the gun affect your fractured mesh, and then we'll talk about some additional resources and where to go from here. All right, so let's get started. First of all, any mesh object can be a destructible mesh, but it also requires that it has a collision assigned to it. So you can turn on collision, or you can drag an object into the scene and I'll hit Alt-C and toggle on collision. If you don't have it on, you can add collision to any object, any mesh object. So this already has collision. Let's right click and create a destructible mesh. Okay, so I'm Alt-rotating this object. You can sort of see in the destructible settings, the default is 25 fractures, and you can preview how it would look if it exploded. You can rotate, Alt rotate it around. If you want a different pattern, you can try a different random seed and refracture. So anyways, that let's say that looks good. In addition, then if you scroll down here, you can go to the things like the fracture effects and plug in like sound effects and particle systems into the mesh itself. So let's kick a little explosion that goes off and a sound effect. We'll say explosion. Okay, and so let's save, scroll up. Maybe the first way that we will do this is enabling impact damage. So one way an object could receive some inputs. Let's go back to architecture. It's worth noting that, so when you create a destructible mesh, it'll put a suffix on there. I prefer to have prefixes, so I'm going to hit F2 and put DM, and I'll just drag it over to my destructible demo and move it here. Let's just move it into the scene. And let's save our scene. So we could simulate PhysX, and PhysX, we can like, as is, we drop this object, it should crack. There we go. So, okay, so the object cracked and fell over, and that's one way to generate. So one thing you can notice too is actually if I turn off simulate physics, we're not getting any like the weapon does not affect that. So let's see, what else do I want to do here? We want to talk about levels and depth. We added particles and sound effects. So let's talk about the radial force actor. So if you haven't used that before, you can just start tiling in radial, and I already have one in my scene here. So I've got a radial force actor in. If you scroll up to the top, you can look. The default, I believe, is at constant. A linear has a little bit of attenuation, so you'll get a fall off from the center, which is kind of nice. And you can, if you scroll down, you're going to want to do things like specifically, I think the default in here for destructible damage is 0, so I set that to a certain number. And the impulse strength, you can dial it to a pretty high number. I think the default is like 1,000, but you know, I'm sort of playing around with numbers. But anyways, let's trigger this with like a key bind. So if we go into the blueprint editor, we hit the K key, then we have that radial force actor selected, and we can fire an impulse off of it. So if you start typing fire impulse, you need to uncheck context sensitive, and there it is. And let's compile. and hit play, I'm going to hit the K key, and bam, there we go, we get a nice explosion. Alright, so one idea would be to go into the first person blueprint and or one solution that I've seen of Tesla, one of Tesla's solutions was to go in and add a radial force actor to the ball, to the sphere, and I'm not going to do that. And I saw another solution I think he also did, which I think I liked better. So I'm going to show that. So basically what it was basically testing from at the location, you check to see were you hitting a destructible mesh. So you cast a destructible actor, and you know if it's true, if it's false, you just destroy the object. But if it's false, so destroy the object. And if it's true, then you can apply radial damage. Apply radius damage. So. And that would be as a destructible actor. And so the hurt origin would be where the hit happens. And then you can set up the base damage. And that sort of goes with you know how you're affecting your object. The radius will make that sort of small. And the impulse strength will make that, I think 1,000 is good. So if we save this off, yeah, we need to attach this event hit to the destructible actor. Let's recompile and see if that fixes it. All right, so now let's go in, play. Now let's quickly go back. I'm gonna hit Control B to select this in the viewport. You can see the damage threshold is set to 1. You can set that to like 5. Also, we can say accumulate damage, and accumulate damage at what support depth? 1, which is where all of the destruction happens. So that's what we want to let's try that out. So you can see now, as I'm shooting at it, it has much more of a perception of actually being affected in a certain way. And you can go back in and balance out your blueprint. So that you know, maybe your base damage is much closer to something that you know looks like it's affecting. All right, so let's. I think the final thing I wanted to show is the define structural support. So one of the things you can do is if you bring this object, over, you can, if you go into the preview depth here, you can select chunks and you go to the chunk parameters and you can turn those chunks into support chunks and say, you know, don't damage them or don't fracture them. And so now if you say, okay, let's see, that there's world support and asset defined support. Now we can sort of put this object, I believe the object's flipped around. So in fact, although I selected the support chunks on this side, I believe that's over here. So we'll try that, and if it doesn't work, then we'll so you just sort of need to like embed it just slightly into this sort of an object over here. So hit F to frame up. Looks like we're good to go. So I'm gonna simulate. So that works. That worked nicely. All right, awesome. So that pretty much covers everything that I wanted to cover, except for some of the resources. I wanted to give a big shout out to Tesla's Destructible tutorials. There's quite a few he did that helped in the putting together of this. Also, Destructible content examples on the Unreal channel. You can download the content examples, really useful. And then where to go from here? I would say where to go from here would be to download or become a Nvidia developer. You can download this thing called the Apex PhysX Destructibles Lab, and you can like bring in your own custom meshes and create some really nice custom slicing. So like if you're sort of tired of just seeing the Voronoi cellular destruction, you probably want to try that tool out, which is really nice. In addition to that, you can go in and you can see the tutorials that they have on their website. Their tutorials are sort of from they have the tool. It's a little bit in an older version, but then they also have some of the demos showing in UDK, but it's pretty much similar. Let's see, what other links do I have? There's a really nice troubleshooting guide. And this like takes you through a lot of frequently asked questions. So that should pretty much wrap it up. Oh, one additional thought would be some additional discussions on the Unreal forums have talked about using like sort of fat actors, the physics actors, as an additional sort of counterpoint to using some of the destructible meshes, depending on how many pieces of how much calculation you're doing. You might be able to like sort of optimize things using fat actors. So that's pretty much it. Thanks so much for watching, and see you later.